Hello and welcome here in the audio showroom at Stjernholm & Company. We have done a couple of presentations on the subject of loudness and got a lot of requests from the outside world if we could do this in English. So here we go. I hope our Danish customers will be able to follow just as well. Also, it was time to kind of update the loudness videos because, of course, changes has happened in standards and so on. In Europe, we have a new standard called R128, and that is being used here in Denmark by Danish national broadcaster TV2 for their file-based deliveries. This video is not going to be very technical. It's more about giving you a basic understanding of what loudness is, because frankly, it's very, very simple. So we won't be covering any advanced technicalities of the subject of loudness, but only this video will have the purpose of actually just making you understand what is it and how to use it. So let's get cracking. Basically, loudness is just the way we perceive sound, how loud we feel it is. And since not all ears are the same, we need some kind of electronic device that can measure sound kind of the same way that our ears does. There's a lot of stuff going into that, stuff like the annoyance factor of sound. You know, one gunshot might just surprise you, but if you hear like 10 gunshots in a row, you will start to say, oh, this is loud. The new loudness standard R128 is trying to take all these things into account so we get a number that describes how loud is this sound. So it's pretty basic. For you guys who think, ah, oh, but I know how loud stuff is because I have a peak meter in my DAW or in my video editing system. That doesn't tell you how loud it actually sounds. It just tells you the electronic values of how hot the signal is. So it's a completely different ballgame. But enough talking to the camera. Let me take you through a couple of examples showcasing actually what loudness means. And we do that by listening to music. During this presentation, it's really important that you don't touch your volume on your computer or your loudspeakers. So set the volume so you feel that my voice is actually at a pleasant level, because this is the nominal level we are going to work at, and I will be set, you know, around the recommended level. So set your volumes and let's go. So here we are. We are going to play back some different music tracks from different decades. This is a normal peak-based meter of the showing the digital scale going to zero. In this example, I have actually had to turn down all the music by 12 dB, so it will the maximum peak of all the music will be here at minus 12. If I didn't do that, you wouldn't be able to hear me during the music segments, and there would be no point in this demonstration. So I had to lower all the music by 12 dB. But all the music is normalized to minus 12 dB, so the highest point in the music for every track is actually hitting minus 12 dB. But enough talking, let's listen. This was how music sounded in the 50s. A little later, it sounded like this. And it actually kept doing that for a while. It was like people got the idea that it shouldn't be too loud. Music should be allowed to breathe a little. And the years went by. So things was sensible for a while. Now we were listening to the same artist that had a particular idea about sound, that it shouldn't be too loud. It should have some dynamics and be able to breathe. And he was really good at that, the late Michael Jackson. But then something happened along the way, and we are going to jump from the last Michael Jackson part onto a ballad, actually, by the singer-songwriter Alicia Keys. And maybe you'll think that I did something crazy here, but I didn't. Michael Jackson. Ballad by Alicia Keys. Jesus Christ. So it almost sounds distorted, but that's the way she wanted it, obviously, because she wanted it to sound really, really, really loud. But that kind of killed the music, didn't it? But it can actually get worse than that. This is a track from a group called Green Day. So basically, that's it. Green Day won the competition. So let's just compare one of the Michael Jackson tracks with the Green Day track. You gotta feel that heat, and we can ride the boogie. Share that beat of love. I'm gonna rock with you all night. Dance you into the sunlight. I'm gonna rock with you. And I won't comment on that. So how does this stack up in our meters? Let's have a look. This was actually Michael Jackson. He was this loud. This was Green Day. They were that loud. Way, way louder than Michael Jackson ever was. But both these songs actually peaks at minus 12 on the normal sample bass meter. So if we were to say how loud is this based on the peak meter, both of the songs would actually slip through a normal technical standards. None of them is too loud. But in a subjective fashion, you experience it yourself, it's way, way louder. You perceive it much louder because it's so compressed. So that is why we need these new standards that measure sound the way we perceive it, instead of just in a technical signal fashion. The first ones to adopt this is naturally the broadcasters that send you TV programming and commercials. The commercial war has had a similar route, deroute, you can say, into bad sound, because everyone wants to sound the loudest in the commercial break. So by adopting this standard, different commercials, no matter how they're mixed, can be loudness normalized to sound the same in terms of loudness. So what is loudness normalization? Let me show you. Let's do a quick measurement. So the result here is minus 18. And remember that these tracks are turned down by 12 dBs. So if we add the 12 dBs on top of this value, so it would be around minus 6, which is actually only 6 dBs from being full-scale pink noise. Amazing. Well done, Green Day. So let's check out Michael Jackson. You gotta feel that heat, and we can ride the boogie. Share that beat of love. I'm gonna rock with you all night. Dance you into the sun. Huge difference there. The measurement for Michael Jackson was around minus 27, so, and Green Day was minus 18. So if we want to loudness normalize these two against each other, I could simply just turn Green Day down. So that's what I'm going to do. They really deserve this, those guys. So let's turn them down. To loudness normalize, I will have to turn Green Day a full 9 dBs down, hitting minus 21 around here. Since it's a loudness, you know, a couple of 0.01 dBs doesn't matter, because it's all about the way we perceive the sound subjectively. So let's see how they stack up now after we turned Green Day down for a loudness normalization. Let's have a listen. Now we get a completely different result. Actually, we can live with the overcompression and loudness of Green Day and still listen to Michael Jackson without having our head ripped off. Fantastic. If we look at the loudness meter, you see that, yeah, it tells the same story. The way you perceive the sound is actually completely the same. That the meter reads out that these two portions of sound was actually the same loudness. So let's have a look at the good old sample peak meter. How loud is Green Day now? See, it plays back way below minus 18 now. Let's have a look at Michael Jackson. The much greater dynamics of the Michael Jackson song actually uses up more on our peak-based meter here. It actually peaks at minus 12. And to compensate, Green Day is actually turned down the 9 dBs and thus being played back much lower. But they sound the same when you listen to it. One doesn't sound much louder than the other. In all its simplicity, that is what loudness measurement is. And the TV station in Europe has set a standard called minus 23. So they would like to have programming and commercials and so on set around minus 23. That way, you won't have to touch your remote control and you can enjoy great sound on your television and not be annoyed by the commercials. And the guys producing the commercials, which is probably also you, you will have the option between wanting to use great dynamics in your commercial, like Michael Jackson, or compressing the hell out of it, like Green Day. You won't be perceived louder. It could be an artistic choice to sound like that, to sound really compressed. But you could also use the dynamics to actually tell the stories of the commercials much better, allowing for much better detail in the sound, because it don't have to be squashed to sound as loud as possible. You can actually have glass breaking and it will sound like glass instead of farts. Thank you for watching, and don't be afraid to send us a mail. Bye.